This is Weekend Mornings on 980 CKNW.
Stirling Faux with you on this Saturday morning. It's in times of crisis that British Columbians come out to help. And Global BC, 980 CKNW, AM 730, and Global Okanagan are partnering for BC Together in support of BC flood relief. Go to cknw.com/BC Together to find ways to help. You can donate to an organization of your choice. They're all there to check out Stepping Up to Help. You can find them at cknw.com/BC Together. Your generous contribution will go to helping our communities in need. It's times of crisis that BC people step up, and a great way to do it, to just check out cknw.com/BC Together. It's a pleasure to welcome our next guest back to the program, a kind of a victory lap this morning, in a way at least, for Adrian Scovell. Mr. Scovell is president and CEO, COO rather, of the BC Automotive Retailers Association. We've been talking about this particular topic for years, literally, on this program. We're talking about specialized and skilled training in BC's automotive industry. And today we're going to talk specifically about EV training. Adrian Scovell, good morning. Welcome back.
Good morning. Nice to be back.
You live in Langley. You got any snow where you are this morning, Adrian?
I do. I am watching it fall right now.
Oh, yes. My. Okay. All right. Well, that's good to know.
You, just as a note, you were right the first time. It's CEO, not COO.
Okay, all right.
It's not critical. I just thought I'd point it out.
You and I have been talking about training and skill training program in British Columbia, literally for a couple of years on this program, Adrian, and to the point where the British Columbia government in recent months has recognized the need to improve skilled training programs in our province, specifically with regards to the automotive industry, and even more specifically, Adrian, on the EV, electric vehicle aspect of BC's automotive industry. We just don't have enough mechanics in this province at all to deal with electric vehicles, do we?
Not even close. But that is on the mend. There are a lot of sort of leading edge people out there right now that are getting their shops ready, and they're getting their people educated and trained. But if we flip the switch to suddenly being electric, that we would have difficulty supporting that, particularly in the outlying areas where you just don't have the resources yet. Nor do we have the equipment. The diagnostic equipment that is necessary is only actually being developed now.
Sure.
We have the next generation of cars we're about to see coming out will require different diagnostic systems. So there's a long way to go, but we're on it.
Well, and again, I suppose, and I said that this is a kind of a victory lap, and I didn't mean that facetiously, because you've been really hammering away on this file for such a long time with no response for most of that time. And all of a sudden, the government says, you know, you're onto something there, you people at the Automotive Retailers Association and various other groups in the province as well, to the point where they're really starting to refocus skilled training, not only in the automotive industry, but certainly in your corner of the economy, aren't they?
Yes. Well, what I would say to that is that we've been hammering on it for a long time with regard to skilled training in general, not even specific to electric vehicles, but mechanical as an industry, and collision particularly as an industry, and other things that really should be recognized for their skill sets. Even, you know, in the towing industry, there's some extremely sophisticated situations that they get into, with $500,000 equipment trying to move vehicles. So there's a long way to go there. We've worked with successive governments, but the NDP, I would say, when they came in and they started listening, very quickly picked up that this was an issue that needed to be dealt with. And it was actually Minister Melanie Mark that got it kicked off and really drove it to the point where it is today. And it's well underway in getting the process, at least, of what are going to be those first wave of trades that will be required certification, and that will be mechanical and collision to begin.
Right.
But how do we go about it? You need the infrastructure under that to make sure you've got the right curriculum and that the training facilities are there to bring them up to the level we need them. So that's what we're working with government on now, us and other stakeholders in various different industries. The first chapter of that has just wound up. Andrew Mercier, Parliamentary Secretary, has been driving that. And the roundtables, he's been having roundtables largely, of course, via, you know, electronic medium, for the past few months, right across the province, talking to all the different industries. And I would say, you know, I have to give government credit where credit's due. They're doing the due diligence to listen and figure out what the obstacles are going to be so they can get well ahead of it.
I'm curious, from the other side, from the consumer demand point of view, I'm looking at your website, which is ara.bc.ca for the Automotive Retailers Association, and I'm on this EV-friendly courses that you've got, and you've got auto recycling, levels one and two, tow truck operators, you mentioned that already, motor dealers, collision repairs, mechanical repairs, all these different options, different angles towards being prepped and ready to deal with electric vehicles. What's the demand like, Adrian, on the other side of that coin? How many people are calling you up or getting in touch with you going, where do I sign up? I really need to get going on this.
Well, we just launched the EVfriendly website, so EVfriendly.ca, which is where it specifically focuses in on EVs.
Okay.
So going through our site, you'll get there, but there's a website set up. So that you'll see it's divided, one side for consumers, the other side for industry. And we just launched, we're in sort of the similar phase, I guess. So I was just discussing, we're doing all of the webinars and the roundtable interviews with various stakeholders, some of the very large collision repair facilities, Craftsman Collision and the Lift Group and the Fix Auto Group, talking to them about getting ready for electric vehicles and what that means. We're talking to BCIT and really it's just in that launch phase. So there's been a great deal of interest actually in this program. Interestingly, as soon as we went out and talked to some of the big guys, I would say, in the industry who operate across the country, the questions are coming back. Well, is this available in other provinces? It's actually, it seems to be something that wants to grow on its own. So we're getting a lot of that preliminary, discussions around what the criteria are going to be. Well, actually, we've got the criteria.
Right.
They're asking us, what are the criteria? And they're saying, okay, now they're sort of looking and getting ready. Because, of course, we can't just go out and say, well, you're certified. Well,
school's open. Let's go. Right.
Yeah, you haven't met the criteria yet.
Sure.
So we're sort of in that phase right now. But the excitement growing around with it is really encouraging. And what we've also learned, well, we knew this through the process, we are ahead of the world, which is really an exciting place to be. There is no other coordinated program that looks at all the aspects of automotive service and repair and coordinates them under one banner, as it were, and is really sort of pushing for that, the full sort of support structure it takes in order to have EVs on the road.
Yeah, it's interesting, Adrian, that you would mention that there is interest coming in from other provinces, and no surprise there at all as more and more of us turn in that direction. What about the government of Canada? This is a huge, huge thing. It's a big initiative, this whole climate change hysteria surrounding the Trudeau government. Have you heard anything, word one, from the feds on any of this?
Not this specific program that we're talking about. I know that they're looking at incentives nationally for the purchase of used electric vehicles. This is somewhere where we need to work, and we're also talking with government here in BC. There's also British Columbia. Again, you have to give it to this province for looking forward. Are looking at a full stewardship program for the recycling of EV batteries.
Right. Yep.
I know that they're talking with federal government. So what is interesting is, the federal government came looking for, feedback on those issues, went to the provincial government, who said, you really ought to call the Automotive Retailers Association here. They're the ones driving these processes. Uh-huh. So we have had some contact there.
Oh, good. Well, that's good to know. And it's also good to know that here in BC, we're kind of at the cutting edge in terms of welcoming not only EVs into our reality and particularly our future, but making the appropriate adjustments so that when they all start to show up in huge numbers, we've got enough people around who can actually fix them and keep them on the road. That's a part that about the EV thing that I don't know how many drivers actually think about, if this thing goes wrong, who's going to repair it? So it's good to know that at least there's something underway. And congratulations. You deserve a victory lap. You've been working on this for years, Adrian, and it's nice to see things go. It's far from done, but it's nice to see things getting done. Well done, sir.
Well, thank you. I appreciate it. What I would say is that you know, this was 2 years ago or so. I was having a conversation with Ken Hendricks, who's our senior representative in this segment of the industry, and we were talking about the goals that government had, and it became very obvious to us it's not going to work unless we inform them that you can't just sell the car.
Yeah.
That's just pushing them out there.
That's right.
You know, there's a lot more to it, and kudos to government. They listened.
Yeah.
So, yes, it's good. And actually, I would say to you too, maybe take a little victory lap too. You and I have spoken about this off and on over the past couple of years. And I know you were very passionate about it when we first talked, because, my goodness, we need to make sure we do have skilled tradespeople. And I think you were a little shocked, as most people were, that you're not required to be certified.
That's right.
Always. And similarly with EVs. Yeah. So. Yeah, it is good. It is good to be in this position where we're well ahead.
Always happy to stick a pin in government on behalf of just about anyone. Adrian, congratulations. EVfriendly.ca. Friends, I've got it up on my screen now. It's a great little website and lots more information about electric vehicles and perhaps a future in electric vehicle maintenance and repair. Coming soon to a trade school near you, courtesy in many ways of the Automotive Retailers Association of British Columbia. Adrian Scovell is the big guy in the snow this morning in Langley. Thanks for this, Adrian. Take care.